wanted to show you the sleigh that we have. The buffalo plaid is inside for decoupage, and I'm going to start working on the outside. As you can see, I've added some bows, some bells, and I'll show you step by step what I did in order to create this look on the sleigh.
We use Crimson Velvet Show Your Jugs kit for both paint and decoupage on the sleigh. A link to the kit is in the comments.
This little sleigh, in fact, I'll show you what it looks like here. And one of these suggestions that came through was to do a buffalo check pattern inside. And I remembered that I had some of these buffalo check napkins, and I'm going to decoupage them inside of this little sleigh. And I think that is going to be really cute. So I'm going to get busy on that right now. I have to take all of these tacks out of here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just start with putting some of the decoupage formula clear coat down first. And then once I have it in place, I'll take my saran wrap or cling wrap, whatever you like to call it, and I will start smoothing this into place. I see some of the places need to have some more clear coat on them. I can take my piece away here. And I'll put some more down. Now the mistake that I seem to make quite often is I overwork my decoupage. And you also want to make sure that you get right on those edges. Okay. And rather than rub it to death, I'm going to put my saran wrap over the top, clear wrap. Don't want to get any copyright issues going here. And I'll just rub it into place. I'll tell you, Dollar Tree has some really beautiful stuff for Christmas this year. Specifically their gift bags. I've been looking at the gift bags, and I've got a little project that I'm looking to do later with those gift bags, because they're too pretty to just throw away or, you know, put away for a whole year. So I'm thinking of some other uses for that, so stay tuned for that. What we have so far. And I've got a second round here. Hopefully you'll be able to see all the way to the edge there. Now I see that I've got just this little white edge here. I'll show it to you. And I don't want that to show because it's just going to be really distracting. So I'm going to use my scissors and just cut that little piece off. Hi, Louie. I can't see a lot of the comments, so if you comment and I don't respond, chances are I'm probably zoning out on you. And that's okay. It's Sunday. It's kind of crummy outside. It's a great day to be inside and just painting. Hi. If you're totally new to Vermont Chalky Paint, it is a non-toxic decorative paint that's mine manufactured, made in Vermont. And its adhesion qualities, it's a non-toxic substitute for polyurethane. And the way it gets its adhesion is through polyway, which is a byproduct of cheese, which is kind of cool. Okay, here we go. And I want to line up the lines on the bottom. And again, don't overwork it when it's at this point. And don't worry about the top being uneven because you're going to even that out with another strip of the decoupage. We're going to decoupage this strip of the napkin on the top, and we're going to finish it off with lace and bows, and off to the races we go. It'll be fine. Going to be great. Going to be great. And the reason for the saran wrap is if you use your hands, it tears really easily because it's basically a tissue. So you just kind of want to smooth it with the plastic wrap in place. And again, if you see places where it's coming loose, like here, I'm going to go over that with the brush and hopefully not get in the way. Hey, Jerry. Good to see you, man. Jerry and I, we were supposed to go to Vermont Country Store for our epic Christmas shopping. And unfortunately, Jerry had some medical issues that changed our plans. But I am glad to see you're doing okay right now, my friend. This is sort of a zen thing to do. I find I get quiet because I think it's the right side of my brain that takes over, and then I can't talk, which makes for probably kind of some boring video for you, but I'll learn to talk eventually. And if you have any questions, I probably won't be able to see you, but I'll certainly answer them afterwards. Oh, that's really cool. I'm pretty happy with that. All right. Now the next exciting episode is I want to have this green trim on the top. I think I'm going to start from this way and work my way back. I think that's how I'll do things. And this is going to even out the red a little bit more here. So again, I'm just going to take my clear coat or my decoupage again. You can get that off of our website. I will put a link in the comments. I have, I think I'm only down to three more crimson velvets left. So if you want this, I highly recommend you order soon. And I'm donating 20% to Relay for Life. And there's so much fun stuff you can do with these little Show Your Jugs kits. They're really fun. Because I figure sometimes you see those paints and stuff and you're like, well, I don't really know what to do with it. That's great, Sarah. What do I do with it? So this is just a little idea. Jerry and I had found this sleigh. We were shopping. Where the heck were we, Jerry? I think we were in Warrensburg. And picked it up for, I don't know, 20 bucks or something like that. And it was pretty beat inside, so I did the buffalo napkins inside. And I said, well, it needs something on the outside. And I think I said something about keeping it simple. And, well, as you can see, keeping it simple kind of went out the window, didn't it? I've got to complicate everything. Does anyone else like to complicate things more than they should? Oh, thanks, Jerry. I'm glad the Christmas colors make you feel better. That's my job, man. That's my job. Make you feel better. All right, so this is measuring something I don't really excel in. But let's see here. If I put it here, and I put my finger glider, and I'll fold it. I don't know where the southern accent came from. I'm one of those fifth generation Vermonters. I don't know much. There you go. Not to say fifth generation Vermonters don't know much. Don't want to get anybody riled up. Because we know sometimes in these times it's easy to get wound. And who needs to get wound, right? All right, so I'm trying to line up with that gold line there. But it might be better if I try to line up with the green on the top. I'm kind of leaning that way, folks. And then I'm going to just ease that in. Fold it, and then I'll cut that with the scissors because I've got the angle that I want. I didn't learn how to sew. I ended up in home ec. Mrs. Drew was my home ec teacher. Me and Neil Boley used to sit in the back and race the sewing machines in the back. I probably should have used my time more wisely because now I wish I'd learned how to sew. But I did have a lot of fun tearing it up with Neil in the back. And the thing is, if you make a mistake, it's not a big deal. It's a flipping napkin. Right? I think we can all take a lesson from napkins. And again, if it gets wrinkly, you just take your saran wrap and try to even it out a little bit there. I don't know how this is looking on the... Oh, thanks, Jer. It's a fun little project. Nice to have my friends with me. I got this selfie stick recently, and I'm really pleased with it. It's been fun to do these projects. Oh, sugar shells. Have to cut another one. I also did not do well in geometry. One of those angles. So this will be a good opportunity for me to show you how to separate the paper. You just tear it anywhere. This is, again, the biggest mistake people make when they're doing decoupage is they don't take enough of the paper off the napkin. And it makes it look kind of chunky. There we go. Try to get that so you can see it. I might very well be sitting right in front of the camera so you can't see what I'm doing. I don't know. I'm kind of a, don't have a big production company yet. Okay. So I'm just going to cut some of this. And I don't know what I will do with this sleigh after. I don't know if I'll sell it or maybe a present. Or don't know yet. All I know is I just wanted to have a little bit of fun with it today. And you gotta make sure that you make sure the green is facing up, because I almost made that mistake just a few minutes ago. So I know that the fold is there. There we go. That's much better. Okay. And I'm just going to leave that tail because I can snip that after. And again, I'm just going to dip into my decoupage. Put this in place. And decoupage rarely looks good out of the gate. Sometimes you have to give it some time for it to set up, and then you start seeing the way that you want it. Okay. So the decoupage portion is over. Now the next thing I want to do, I got to look at the other side here. So I had put the lace on the top of the green, and I think I'm going to continue that look. I had cut this in advance. So, and this is really, this is just stapling. Let me get my staple gun. Pardon my back. That can't be fun to watch. Sorry. Louie's probably looking at me saying, "Oh, Sarah, how could ya? You're a professional broadcaster." I'm very appreciative of you guys watching. That was really awesome. Makes my day. And I'll just put a few staples in here. There we go. All right. She's starting to come together. And then I just need a little piece right for the end. And yeah, you could hot glue this, but I just found the staples gave it a little more strength. So, and I cover a lot of it with the bows anyway, so you're not really gonna see these staples. Alrighty. Well, the next exciting episode. Again, sorry for my back. Go. So as far as the bells are concerned, I think I'll staple back here too, because I can always cover